from the other topics. This one is just a numerical simulation. So then is how to solve the some application. So I use some Navier Stokes equation. So there are just three key ideas to solve the core annulus growth. One is the Levinson method, and the other one is the boundary condition capture method. And the third one is the time splitting, axisymmetric time splitting numerical method. So I'll explain first what is the core annulus growth and then how to solve it. Core annulus flow is a pressure-driven flow through a pipe, one fluid in the core and another fluid in the annulus. What is that is the, if you, in the oil industry, there is some oil transportation. So in the pipe, there is some, you should transport the oil, right? But because of the, because the viscosity of oil is much higher than the water, so just put the oil in the pipe, then the oil is not moved, just stick in the water. So we need some lubricative some material. So usually we use just some water. So that gives the oil is transported to the maybe Alaska to the Korea or Alaska to the Los Angeles. So that is. You can see the density and some viscosity difference. Then is the, we need to solve the two-phase flow. So this is just fluid. So we need to solve the two-phase Navier Stokes equations. So I show the examples. This one is actually an experimental result. So this is pipe here. So inside is core, is oil, and outside here is water. So in steady state case, it looks like a bamboo. So we say that the bamboo wave. So this is experimental result by Giuseppe Leonardi. So the, our result is looks like this. So it depends on the parameter. So I, one parameter is I explain later. So we can simulate this one. So why we simulate this one, this kind of things? Because of the oil industry, they need some much oil to transport. If you put the water a lot, then you can transport the oil, but we need to just adjust the ratio of the oil and water. So we put the, more oil than water, so how much you can put. So if we put the oil a lot more than in this case, then maybe this one is maybe stick to the wall, then it cannot move. That's the problem. Or maybe some strange wave will develop here. So just first I show just some simulation. So this is initial data. So this is pipe. Then this is water. This is oil. Then yeah, this is the simulation. You can see the wave will change and become a bamboo. It looks like a bamboo wave. So this is a state solution. So you run the Navier Stokes equation. And just look like this. This is the state solution. So then I explain how to solve this one. So two-phase Navier Stokes equation is this one. And then incompressible Navier Stokes equation is there's some jump in the inside between oil and water. So then we solve this one directly. That is a really difficult. So, but Bradley developed this one. So, this is some internal force, right? So then this one is including the equation. Then you just some delta function. So this one is actually P is a vector function. So then it's just locally, this force is just in the interface, so local force. Nissan users and local folks. So originally we sold this one because the include the inside the boundary condition is to solve this one is very difficult. So but we developed me and Sumitomo Miyu and Ron Pat to develop the boundary condition, then we directly solve the these equations. That is for the boundary condition experiment. So first I explain how to solve this one, but this is similar. So later I explain how to solve this one directly. So but you already saw the picture, there is just a horizontal wave. There is a pipe is 3D, but you can prepare the axis symmetry. So we use the axis symmetry 2D compressor level, we solve the 2D compressor level specification. So like this. But this is very complicated, you solve the numerical method. Also the time consuming is very high. So we need some special techniques. Also, we need some initial condition. So this one is from the experimental result and some modeling. So this is centralized velocity. This one is actually we just use some Leonardi's papers. So V0 is centralized velocity. That is in the center of the pipe. So this is base velocity. So with the water and water and oil is moving initially like this. So this R1 is the, I2 is the radius of pipe. R1 is initial radius of the oil. So I already mentioned that we need some Levinson method, right? So by in the numerical method, we have some usually two methods, FEM or FDM, finite difference or finite element method. So, but in this case, we want to use a finite difference method. Then is we need to agree. But the water is, but this thing is just bubble, but I explained the easier way. So if we have a bubble like this, then it's two-phase flow. So it's, there is a boundary condition here. So pressure boundary condition, pressure jump equals sigma k, something like that. So the grid, so we needed to develop the boundary condition here. So that is a boundary condition capture method. So also, this one is moving, then we need some Levinson method. So it capturing some surface, that is the Levinson method, which is developed the stem of the. So Levinson method, many audience already know that, so just a distance function from the interface. So inside or outside is anything you want. So in this case, it's X, oil in the negative, water is positive. So then you solve the some dissipation, then it's the interface moving. So U is come from the Navier specification. So explain again. So this is the gamma, is the p equals zero. I already mentioned that. So we solve this equation or Hamilton-Jacobi equation. So this type of equation, I told you, Hamilton-Jacobi equation, we need a special technique. Use some Eno scheme or Wiener's or some Mussel scheme. So this one is also explained. What is the Levinson method? Or why we use the Levinson method? Levinson method is the, this one is a key idea. Topological change, such as merging or break, is handled with this approach. That's the key idea. Also, method is Eulerian, so that is easy to develop a new method. Also, Levinson method, that is special, so geometric feature, like normal vector or curvature, is without calculating anything, just using a Levinson. So this one is just explain the Levinson tools. So normally, if you give a Levinson, then normal is like this, and curvature is like this. This one is just given. So other things is in Irish. representation. So in the core inverse flow, so we need a rho and mu is difference, right? So we use like this, rho oil and plus rho water minus rho oil is Heaviside function. That gives inside is maybe just rho p equal rho oil and mu p equal mu oil. So in the outside of the oil, that gives just rho water. But numerically, we need something like HP is just what? There's a jump. So numerically, we cannot differentiate. We need some differentiation this one. So then we made some smoothness of this one. So that gives us some oscillation, not oscillation, smoothness, and maybe lost some accuracy. Usually we solve the Navier-Stokes equation, we need some dimensionless technique. So we develop the dimensional technique and then for TP is the Rayleigh number and Weber number, like this. So depending on this one, the oil and water feature is decided, actually. So you can see that this one is very complicated. So, but usual idea is solving the Navier-Stokes equation in the previous method. That is usual technique. But this one is just easy to solve. But difficult one is this one actually, and next page actually. So this one is solved, this one, but the pressure is we did not solve yet. But maybe this one. You have also Navier-Stokes equation, then you use so intermittent, we solve the intermittent value. But because of incompressibility, using this two equations, we have some Poisson equation. But this one is just, you can see just Poisson equation, then you can solve it. But it's there is just some rho. Rho is some jump, right? So you cannot differentiate. Also, there is a condition, pressure condition. Pressure jump equals sigma k in the between oil and water. So that gives the very difficult to solve it. So this kind of example is here. Just you can see one dimensionally. There is this one, looks like this one, right? Just Poisson equation and jump condition. So if we have some initial condition like this, then we solve it, then because of the we cannot differentiate this one, then it gives something oscillation here using just use a numerical technique. But ghost fluid idea or some ghost fluid, looks like ghost fluid idea, then we develop the boundary condition method. Then we just using a jump condition. We already know jump condition. Then we differentiate using some jump condition. So we can do the this one. So usually you differentiate this one, then make AX equal U, AU equal F. So then is solve the symmetric system. But because it jump, that's different. But in here, the differentiation is a usual differentiation plus some known terms. That is, this one is going to the right hand side. That gives AU equals F prime. That means almost same as the solving the AU equal F. So that is, this one is also, explaining is the pressure jump equals sigma k, that is the source force. There is something like a force. Force term is going to the right hand side.
When
the
jetpack goes through the A over the jetpack, then
which
one?
Which one? Which one?
What? I mean, A
over
the
jetpack is small, you mean?
Jetpack is small.
But jetpack is actually some grid size. Yeah, it's, maybe you can make a small, but it's, this side is going to right hand side. That's kind of the matter. Because of this is not a continuous function, this is a discrete function. So you can control the some delta x. Now delta x is not goes to zero. Usually the numerical is that the theory is always delta x goes to zero, there is some numerical method converging, right? But in the practically, delta x is some limitation. So it cannot go infinity. Also, the another one is the, this one is the same equation, but the jump condition is one differentiation jump. There is almost same. The solution looks like this. There is also same. Also, this one is some force term, so this one is going to right-hand side. That gives, we can solve the Poisson equation plus the jump condition in the inside. So the result is looks like this. Then it's just a sample. The example looks like this. We just known a known solution. Then we solve the Poisson equation plus jump condition. Then the result is just usual method is may take a medical oscillation here. Also this one you can see, there's a jump here. So this is numerical solution. That means no smear out anywhere. Okay, usual method is make smear out make 4 or 5 points. That gives some area loss or some other things happen. So solving the Quine's rule is just Lewis function, define Lewis function in the whole region and then endless region. And time integration is maybe TV times logic 3 or TV logic 2. So update Lewis set and update wood and water. Also, there's a Lewis method, there's just some one trick way to reinitialize this function, Lewis function. There's a trick way. But problem is the here is just using a explicit method. Then because this one here is second derivative, that gives a time restriction. Then make we need a lot of time to simulate this one. So we made a implicit scheme. So you just start and then start here. Okay. So also U and V same thing here. So this one gives semi implicit formation. Just like this. Then is we arrange right hand side to the U star or V star. Then looks like this. This one or this one. Okay, U equals this one, V equals this one, then split pump. You can solve this one. But the problem is usual discretization of this one, that gives a non-symmetric matrix. Usual non-symmetric matrix is worse than the symmetric matrix. So we use some factorization method, this one is a symmetric method. How? Here. Just a factorization like this. But this one is not exactly the same as this one. But in numerically, we may solve that this one is O over delta x squared. But this one is also O over delta x squared. That is okay. Then numerically, it's almost you can get the same result. So this one gives the symmetric matrix. Also, this one is a symmetric matrix. Then you can solve some easily. Also, you have some many methods to solve this kind of matrix system. The easier way is the PCG, frequently conjugate method. The time step restriction is the usual way. Also, reinitialization. But this one is the usual way we solve this one. But there is another way using some fast sweeping method or fast matching method. But just usually explain like this. So then you solve this one, then you can get this kind of thing. This one is just a old profile, contour profile here. This one is a pressure profile. So here is the pressure like this. But just the isolve here is just a horizontal pipe. But just this is the vertical pipe. But horizontal is very difficult because this one is we can assume that the pipe is axisymmetric. by its horizontal is, but we cannot use axisymmetric regime because of the Bezier gravity. Also, then is we can solve the 3D, not 2D. Okay? Also, then this one is just square, but it's horizontal is not square. This is, horizontal is just pi. That means the domain is the just something like a cylinder. Okay, then you consider the boundary condition of the cylinder also. That is very difficult. So I'm limited to the solving the method, but that regime, but it's maybe I'm trying, but so maybe next year I can get some solutions. Also take a lot of time. So here is some parameter that you give this one. So this is something real parameters. But also this is another parameter, but you can see the this one. Some strange thing happens here. But this is that I will show you. Yeah. If you give us a wrong parameter, they develop like this, they stick here. So we can control the amount of the oil, oil and water. Using this kind of parameter. Okay. Also, something like this happens. Oh. But it's meant to be beautiful. Also, this one is also some breaking the oil. But this is some simulator. This one then is breaking. I mentioned that the Levinson method is the very useful for the change of like topological change. So that's why this one is developed here. But this one is not so good result because of the parameter is wrong. This one is a really bad result. Not bad result, bad, we choose a bad parameter. So then give the like this. So in the real problem, it has this kind of parameter. Now this is just test, but it's not the 3D horizontal problem, just use just an axisymmetric, we assume that that is symmetric, just 2D. But it's not a real good result, but it's just a pure result for 2D. But it's, I will develop the 3D right now. Yeah, I think we are starting.
Any questions for the speaker?